If you got faith in a God that can take that which is wrong and make it right. No matter how big or how bad the trouble might be, we got a God that can change it and make it all right. But the devil wants you to say that we're not going to make it. But what do your faith say? I'm just about through. I'm going to go ahead and get into my tent and go back to that showing light room. Amen. And I'm going to sit down and get out of y'all way.
Preach.
Looking at the subject in 2 Kings, I want to look at it big piece by piece. It says, verse 19, it says, and he said unto the father, the son went into the field with the father and the servant in the field, and all of a sudden his hand began to hurt. He said to the father, Father, my hand, my hand. Yes. You know, we father, we do the best we can, but we ain't Dr. Father, it's Dr. Mom, y'all know that. And so the father sent the lad to the house to his mother to carry him to his mother. Sometimes mama don't have to do nothing, lay hands on people, all right. Just want mama to touch him. Send him to his mama, and so the servant took him to his mama. He crawled in his mama's lap and sit on his mama's knee. There he sit until noonday. But at noonday, the Bible said he died. Yeah. Mother, how do you feel if your child crawled in your lap, complaining about a headache? You think it's going to pass? It'll seem to go away as soon as you get a little sleep and he'll be all right. And he sits in your lap and he dies.
Right.
Many of them, no doubt, when the plot fell off with a tackle and had a fit and cried and boo hooed and just went all over and called everybody and said, my child is dead.
Yeah,
but I want to bring y'all something about this woman. Here she's sitting with a dead child in her lap, and the Bible said she got up with the dead child and went to the room that they have built on the house for the man of God and laid him on the man of God's bed. Then it says she shut the door behind her.
Yes.
Didn't call 911.
Yeah.
Didn't call the undertaker.
Yeah.
Didn't call for the rescue squad. Didn't call for the paramedics. Put him on the man of God bed and shut the door.
Yeah.
And walked out and called to her husband and said, I want to go see the man of God. Wait a minute, did you tell your husband something? You just laid a dead child in the bed on a man of God. Did you really tell your husband the boy's dead?
Yes.
When she said to her husband, I need to go see the man of God.
All right.
He said, why do you need to go see the man of God? It's not the new moon. And it's not Sunday. Why do you need to go see the man of God? Is something wrong? She said to her husband, all is well. And what do your faith say?
Amen.
When your situation dies in your lap.
Yes.
When pop come and kill your hope.
Yes.
Destroy your dream. What do your faith say?
My thought is that.
Do you get up and throw in the towel and throw your peanut butter? Or do you say, all is well?
All right. Yes. Amen.
Preach it.
Here, her husband thinking that the son is okay, he's just in there sleeping. She said, all this way. Just allow me to go see the man of God. So her husband called the servant, he got the ass and they put him on and they began to go down to see the man of God. This year with a dead son at the house. And she's taking a trip. Dead son laying on the bed and she's going downtown. Get near the man of God, he see her coming his way. Send a servant out to meet her, he said, go see what she wants, go see what's going on. Thinking that something was wrong, thinking that something was going wrong, that she was being destroyed, that she was all torn to pieces. Go and see what's wrong with her. And the servant got to her and said, what is wrong with you? Is something wrong with you? Is something wrong with your husband? Is something wrong with your child? And the woman said again,
all
is well. What do your faith say? When the children are cutting up.
That's right.
Acting up.
All right.
Going contrary to the way they've been brought up.
Amen.
fighting off their sin. When the pretty kids are going crazy, won't listen to mama nor grandma. Fighting off their sin.
Amen.
Husband won't act right then. Wife won't do right. What do your faith say?
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus. Is your husband okay? All is well. You okay? All is well.
Amen.
How about the child? What, the one dead on the bed back there? All is well.
Amen.
When life was in us in trouble, when life was in us with problems and situations, how do we respond? How do we react? Do we run around town and tell everybody what you're going through?
Yes,
let me pause for a minute and help you out.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can't tell everybody what you're going through. You can't tell everybody what's happening.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Because everybody don't have the faith that you need to join with your family.
Yeah.
I studied this lesson and I looked up and said, why did you tell the husband about the child? Or why did you tell the servant about the child? But she realized she needed somebody with their faith.
Yes.
That would touch her.
Yes.
And she drew that faith on the man of God when he told her about she going to have a child.
Yes.
He and her husband were old and she hadn't had a child. He said, this time next year she's going to have a child. And wow. It happened.
Yeah.
Just like he said.
Yes,
sir. She said, I believe the child can live. I believe the child will be all right if I can get somebody to join their faith with me.
All right.
So she bypassed. She didn't go with a sorrowful story. She didn't go with weeping and moaning. She went to ask all this way. She was not speaking about what she saw. The devil wants you to talk about what you see, how things are, how things feel, how people see you. But God wants you to speak because they are not. She know everything going okay in the natural. She know everything going okay with her son, but in the spirit. Because she understood that faith moved mountains.
Yeah.
She understood that faith will bring the path what you decide to see.
Yeah.
In other words, it's not so much of what you see now, but what you want to see.
Yeah.
We have to believe God and learn how to start speaking what we want to see, rather than what we see. Our natural eyes see the trouble coming our way.
Yeah.
Our natural eyes see all the problems coming our way.
Yeah.
All right,
look like there's no way right now. Did y'all see those three Hebrew boys when they were being thrown in that fire first? They didn't tell you what they saw. They didn't care what used to happen when people get thrown in the fire. They didn't say, oh boy, we get ready to run out now.
He laid on the bed, listening to him.
He got back in church, went up down the church shouting, told his testimony. Said, I was in the hospital and I heard somebody talking in my room. Said, it won't be long now. Because he got that guilt, that sin in his head. But what do y'all face? Sir? He said, I know I won't go nowhere. I already talked over to God. And God told me